They basically got him the same outfit, just new.
Cass has lots of character traits that I don't like. I don't like his voice. I don't like his posture. He latches over. And part of it, I feel like it's my fault.
I gotta be honest, there's a part of Cass that I don't like either.
Yeah.
And that's that he doesn't look at me when I talk to him. Yeah. He literally looks away at the most inopportune times. Yeah. We're in the middle of a scene and he's just... But when it's his turn to talk...
I don't know where he gets that.
Where did that come from?
I don't know where he gets that.
Because... He
really annoying.
Not really aware that we're going to be married to forever.
And the term choices is a strong word as well.
It is. Sometimes it's just like
something happens.
Here's an example for Dean. In season one, we go to talk to somebody about thank you, Kurt and Tinder.
We do a little product placement here.
This is this is really good apple juice. It smells like it's probably maybe 16 years old.
17 years old.
In season one. In season one, we went to talk to somebody about something like Sam and Dean to get information about a case. And there happened to be some hors d'oeuvres on the table that this person decided to leave there. It wasn't written in the script, it was a direct thing. He's like, you know, maybe put some crackers and cocktail sausages and things out on the table. Well, I just was like, hey. As a joke, you know? Because, hey, we have a saying on the set of Supernatural that there's no joke to cheat. And I decided that was a little, gonna be a funny thing. Then Dean proceeded to be written as this glutton of fast food and junk food for the next 8 seasons. And it literally was off of those little sausages that I just randomly wasn't even, I'm not even sure they were supposed to be eaten. I checked with my props department afterwards and I'm like, listen, were those even good? They didn't taste good. And Robin, bless her heart, was like, yeah, they weren't meant to be eaten. She's like, it's okay, they were fresh, but they weren't meant to be eaten. I'm like, well, I'm sorry, do you have another bag? Because I'm just...
And a doctor.
I'm now going to need. So anyway, yes, there are. It's interesting because we make kind of decisions or choices even spur of the moment. Things happen, within a scene or within an episode that that then they continue to write for. And that's part of the process of character in a television series is the actor does things and the writers watch this and then they start writing towards what the actor's doing and they start, it's a collaboration as the character develops. So I'm sure that there are things that Misha is like, man, why did I do the voice thing? and me as well. You know, why did I decide to do the voice thing? Because that's I don't
talk like this all the time.
Or the Neanderthal thing that you do.
Or the Neanderthal thing that I do. Yeah, that's actually I like that. That's kind of yeah.
Nice, actually.
Anyway, yeah, there you go. Sorry.
Hi.
Hi,
guys.
Hi.
Hi. First, I'd like you to say, please, would you give a love to Jared and tell him we missed him?
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. I'm glad that you brought that up. Is there a way to bring up the house lights a little bit?
Yes.
Can we do that? Real quick. I'm gonna video you guys just for like 2 seconds. And I'm gonna send it to the tall guy. And I'm gonna.
Can you bring him up even more?
Can you bring him up even more? Is there a way to get the.
Back of the
house? If not, it's fine. The sound will be fine. What do you think? We miss you, Jared? Is that.
We love you.
We love you. What's a strong word?
We like you?
We like you, yeah.
Just that it doesn't have the same punch, though.
It doesn't. Yeah.
We don't mind you.
We like you.
Okay.
All right, let me just, I'm going to start. And.
I'll have it.
Okay.
We love you.
We miss you, Jared. Okay, hang on. Here we go. We're recording. I'll send that to him. So there you go.
I wasn't done yet. I'll have to read it off because of time.
Yeah.
I would like to take this opportunity to thank you for all the hard work, all those long hours, and all the dedication that makes Supernatural so special and amazing to us.
Thank you. All right, so we're going to make a video for the crew.
But maybe you can pass it on in some way.
We will. And you know what? And we do. The crew is, you know, whenever we get to do these things, we come back and we tell the stories and the stories that you give us, we relay those to the crew and they are, I wish you all could meet them. They're our family. They're an amazing bunch of people, and they work very, very hard to make a really quality product, I think. And they're the true heroes in my eyes. So thank you for acknowledging them because they're awesome.
They don't see their family. Physically abusing them that much.
Well,
Jared's broken a few ribs.
Yes. By hugging people too hard.
So it's your fault. Because we're just trying to embrace them as though
they love us this much.
This is how much they love you.
Yes, but they are the unsung heroes. And thank you for acknowledging.
Started, as a matter of fact.
No, and a shout out to the whole JITCON staff for a wonderful event and the awesome organization, and we had a great time. It takes a lot of effort and people, and I just wanted to use the chance to.
Thank you, Daniela. Thank you so much.
Is there a question in our future at all, or was that the whole?
That was it? Oh, you're very sweet. Not that you didn't have a question, you just, that was a very sweet thing to say. Thank you, that's awesome. And yes, the staff here at this convention, it's, you know, that's another reason why we love to come here. It's to see you guys. It's a well-run machine here, and it's just a good place to be. So, thank you to the staff here. Thank you to you guys. Thank you.
Where did they go when they die in purgatory?
Purgatory.
It's a subsidiary of Purgatory.
It's a village within Purgatory.
It's called
Purgatory. It's quite nice.
It is quite nice, actually. A wonderful bakery.
Yeah. Yeah. I stayed at lovely B&B there for a little while.
There was a great B&B there. Yeah.
Thank you.
I
meant to say was, oh, that's very interesting.
During the time of last year, you were all the earliest acting with the
man.
And as a result, I had a few comments being made about some of the unusual things you had listed, but also some kind of everyday skills like kayaking, ice skating, and bike riding.
Bicycle touring, actually. Bike riding is lame on bicycle touring.
Did you remember some of those comments were like, I'm pretty sure anybody can run, or Brian or Dino. And if you were told about bicycle touring, I'm pretty sure that's just bicycle. I'm just wondering how you feel about that. These comments came from somebody who also has bicycle touring listed on his resume. And then track listed in his list.
Yeah, go ahead, man. Go ahead. You know what, it scares me a little bit.
Show me the picture of this guy. So this is, yeah, this is.
embarrassment.
No, this is good. This is good stuff.
Do you have his old one?
Do you?
Can I?
Yeah, you get a point for the extra E at the end. Theatra.
Theatra?
Yes. Theatra.
Where? Oh, Theatra.
Yes, Theatra.
Hey, I would like you to look at the title heading of that.
Yeah, you are an agent.
What says William Morris Agency on the top, which means I did not write any of that.
Oh, come on.
No. What special skills?
So they,
skills and experience. Let's go. Go, go.
Dance. Don't gloss over that.
Oh, that was one.
Yeah.
Oh, you're like, let's dance.
No.
Yeah.
Dance. So what happened is you called up William Morris. You're like, hey guys, listen.
Hey, listen, I can dance.
I can dance. Like I'll dance.
Don't worry, I'm telling you guys, I can dance. Can I have your music, please? Any kind of music.
I see now that you were
angry. That's good. You were talking. They were not. And I raise you.
Don't lose this.
I will see your dance, and I will raise you accents. Now that was too easy. You did it all the time.
Give me a break. What kind of word is it? What will do simply I said, what is a way of what business you're doing? What is very interesting, at the time when you go into audition, if they want to see you perform or bit, what you do? Because I want one thing for the director, casting director, producer, or anything. I want you to know what is special, okay? What is special? That's it. I heard something in the room that is special. Yes. I can't go my audition.
I want to tell you, but I can do the lines from sort of days of life, right? And I even speak to you at a teardrop and weeping, hip chest, breathe hard, everything. And then what I say to you, but first I want to know also, thank you sir, very much, gracious. And the audition, I want you to know, sir, that I do boogie boarding. I use soccer, football, swimming, baseball, bicycling. If you need someone to bicycle in your film, I can do, but I cannot do bicycle touring. Just bicycle only. I'm not quite a dance for bicycle touring. And also, I can do ice skating, track, dance, sing. agent. I have what's on.
Well, I'm just gonna go down the list. Tibetan throat singing. You know what? Can you really ride a horse? This is horseback riding, and I'm fairly certain that Misha hasn't spent a lot of time on the back of a horse. Listen, I grew up in Texas, and I probably haven't spent as much time on a horse as I should have. But I guarantee that I spent more time on a horse than you have.
Oh, yeah?
And Shetland ponies don't count. Nor do Great Danes.
Oh, I'm serious. As long as the animal is asleep, I'm fine.
I mean, come on, man. This, you know, I'm just gonna read them off. Accents, Tibetan throat singing, EMT certification. Appalachian clogging. Appalachian clogging.
You know what?
Can I do some music?
No.
Just hold your horses.
No, don't. The music is broken. Unfortunately.
Okay. All right.